Hello students, I am Dr. Harkaval Singh. Today we are going to study structure and functions of parathyroid gland. First of all, we will discuss location of parathyroid gland. Parathyroid glands are situated in the back of thyroid gland. These are four small glands present, two on each side of thyroid gland. Structure of parathyroid gland. The cells of parathyroid gland are arranged in compact mass, not in the form of follicles like in case of thyroid gland. It has two types of cells, chief cells and oxyphil cells. These cells are also embedded with the pools of red blood cells. Chief cells. Chief cells are small polygonal cells with round nuclei. These are arranged in cords present a whorl-like appearance. Cytoplasm of chief cells is filled with regularly shaped granules. These are occasionally present as clusters. Chief cells are responsible for the synthesis and secretion of parathyroid hormone. Oxyphil cells. Oxyphil cells are larger in size as compared to the chief cells. These cells are found singly or in small groups. These are less numerous as compared to the chief cells. Hormones secreted from the parathyroid gland. Parathyroid secrete a single hormone that is known as parathormone. It is a long peptide of 84 amino acid units. Parathormone and thyroid hormone calcitonin work antagonistically to regulate the calcium phosphorus balance in the blood. Parathormone is secreted in response to the humoral stimuli. When amount of calcium decreases in the capillary blood, it stimulates the parathormone glands to secrete parathormone. Parathormone is a most important regulator of calcium hemostasis of blood. It is also known as hyperkalemic hormone, which regulates the amount of calcium within the blood. It increases the amount of calcium in the blood. Parathormone increases the blood calcium level by three different ways. It increases the release of calcium from the bones. It also stimulates the kidneys for decrease the loss of calcium in the urine. It also stimulates the vitamin D for enhanced absorption of calcium from the intestine. In these three ways, parathyroid hormone increases the level of calcium in blood. Feedback control of parathormone. As we have already discussed that low level of calcium in blood stimulate the release of parathormone from the parathyroid glands, and parathyroid glands further increase the level of calcium in blood by three different ways, by releasing the calcium from bones and by increasing the absorption of calcium from the intestine or by decreasing the excretion of calcium by the kidneys. In this way, the parathormone increases the level of calcium in the blood, and when level of calcium increases in the blood, it produces a negative feedback effect which further stimulates the parathyroid glands to decrease the release of parathormone. With the decrease in parathormone, the level of calcium in blood also decreases, and with the decrease in level of calcium in blood, again it produces a positive feedback for the release of parathormone from the parathyroid gland. In this way, secretion of parathormone is controlled by the positive and negative feedback mechanism. Functions of parathyroid gland. As we have already discussed that parathyroid glands produce parathormone. Parathormone further regulates the amount of calcium, content of calcium in the blood. It helps in to maintain the strong bones. Now we will discuss disorders of parathyroid gland. First of all, we will discuss hypoparathyroidism. In case of hypoparathyroidism, lesser amount of parathormone is produced as compared to the normal amount. First of all, we will discuss etiology. There are various reasons for the lesser production of parathormone, like family history, any kind of autoimmune disorder, or excessive treatment with the help of radiations, and low levels of magnesium in blood also responsible for the lesser production of parathormone. Now we will discuss pathogenesis. Hyposecretion of parathormone lowers the concentration of calcium ion in blood and tissues due to the calcium excretion in urine. This increases the excitability of muscles. That's why it causes tingling sensations and also causes the muscle spasm. It may cause the heavier periods in case of female cataracts. Due to the loss of calcium, hair and skin becomes dry and nails may become brittle. It may cause the weakening of tooth enamels in kids. Now we will discuss the treatment of hypoparathyroidism. To restore the amount of calcium and mineral balance in our body, we take vitamins with calcium and vitamin D. Now we will discuss hyperparathyroidism. When production of parathormone is more than the normal limits, etiology. First of all, we will discuss the reasons behind the hypersecretions of parathormone. It may be increased due to the development of parathyroid tumor. Pathogenesis. Hypersecretions of parathormone results in the excretion of more calcium from the bones, which make the bones weak and it may cause pain in the bones and it causes depression in the human being, and it may result in the frequent urination, and it may cause kidney stones due to the higher accumulation of calcium content within the kidneys. It causes nausea and loss of appetite. Treatment. Hyperparathyroidism may be treated by removing the tumor surgically from the parathyroid glands. Now we will discuss osteoporosis. Osteoporosis is the disease which may be caused due to hyperparathyroidism. Etiology: loss of calcium from the bones due to the higher production of parathormone may cause osteoporosis. Now we will discuss pathogenesis. In case of osteoporosis, bones become very thin, bones break and fracture more easily as compared to the normal person, and it causes loss of energy and person may feel old and bones hurt very easily. Treatment. Osteoporosis, if it is due to the hyperproduction of parathormone, it may be cured by removing the bad parathyroid gland or parathyroid tumor, which is responsible for the higher production of parathormone. Thanks for watching.